Thank you. So, why Springfield?
I get asked that a lot, and I choose to live here because Springfield is a place that I can enjoy the life I want.
I love the outdoors.
We can be on the lake in just a short drive.
It only takes me 10 minutes to get to work.
Or off to anywhere in the world.
I know my kids will be safe and well educated.
There are really good job opportunities after graduation.
I'm able to work remotely and create on a high level.
The healthcare options in this area are incredible.
The options for housing and cost of living are so affordable.
We have room to create.
I love to experience the excitement of sports.
Can't beat the food.
Or the drinks.
Why Springfield? Because all the pieces you need to create your own story are here. The only thing missing is you.
How do you become the person you're really meant to be? How do you reach beyond what you thought was possible? The answer isn't about the destination. It's in the journey. It starts when you become part of something bigger, when you join a community that works together to lift each other up, a place where you form lifelong relationships and encounter life-changing experiences. It all starts when you go beyond. At Drury University, we take a personalized approach in combining hands-on learning, meaningful mentorship, and real-world results to make sure you have every opportunity to succeed in both your life and career. Maybe it's fusing your passion for research with your devotion to caring for others, or turning your love of learning into a lifetime of teaching. Maybe it's realizing a busy life doesn't mean you have to give up on your lifelong dreams. Or using music to do something more than just entertain. Or combining your entrepreneurial spirit with your affection for the arts. The path you take is up to you, but you won't be alone. Along the way, you'll receive mentorship from faculty who take the time to understand you, whether it's staying after class to look over an assignment or just hanging out during office hours. Your journey starts here, but the Drury experience goes beyond the boundaries of the classroom and around the world. So get outside your comfort zone, join a club, play a sport, get loud, take center stage. Ask to have class outside just because you can. Fuse your brightest ideas with your best memories. And if you get knocked down, get back up. We'll be here for you. This is your journey. This is where you belong. Look around. This is where you become who you're meant to be.
Today will not be easy, but you did not choose the easy path. Easy is not who we are. We are
Fury.
You will be tested every minute that you are out there, and you will be better for it. We are
Fury.
There's no time for fear in this room. When I look in your eyes, I see focus. I see intensity. I see an unrelenting desire to be unstoppable.
You have been waiting for this moment, and your moment is here.
Who are we?
We are Fury!
Who are we?
We are Fury!
Who are we?
We are!
WebSportsRadio.com in association with KBFL proudly presents Missouri State University.
And live from Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena. No, it is not the Ice Bears. This is Drury Panther Hockey. Hello, everybody. Steve Casson along with Scott Letsky and Amari Johnson on the camera. Yeah, we can't keep our team straight. No, but it's the Drury Panthers coming in at number 35 versus Southern Illinois Edwardsville at number 31. The Drury Panthers are 4-2 this season. They're back on the ice after 2 weeks removed from suffering a pair of losses, 6-4 to Maryville on Friday, September 29th, and 6-2 on Saturday, September 30th. The Panthers had a 2-1 lead in game one until three Saints goals in 10 minutes turned the tide, but the Panthers tied the game 4-4 midway through the third period until a pair of late goals netted by Maryville gave them the win. Game two started with a 3-0 Maryville lead midway through the first period, and the Panthers could not recover from the Saints' quick start in the loss. Let's take a look at the leading scorers for the Drury Panthers, and no surprise, it's the top line for the Panthers. Keegan Ferguson, 6 goals, 12 assists, has 18 points, and is tied for first with Jacob Hawley, who has 5 goals and 13 assists to lead the Panthers in scoring. Ferguson has a 3-game goal-scoring streak and is second on the team in goals. Holly was held scoreless against Maryville on September 30th, losing a three-game point scoring streak, but he is the assist leader with 13 for the Panthers. Ethan O'Rourke, he is third with 8 goals and 8 assists and leads the team in goals. He has a 4-game point scoring streak and 6 goals in 4 games. In fact, all 3 of the goals versus Marquette on September 22nd were on the power play. But most of the offense, as I mentioned, is through the top line, who have outscored opponents 36-18 this season. Patrick Labutis moves into fifth place with 3 goals and 3 assists. He netted a goal against Maryville on Saturday, September 30th. He's one of 16 players to have a point this season for the Drury Panthers. Taking a look at some of the goaltenders for the Panthers, and Grayson Skirpan took the loss September 29th, facing 40 shots. He's now 1-1 this season, and he's faced 66 shots in 2 games, but he does have a .909 save percentage. Brett Sweet is also 1-1 after a 6-2 defeat on September 30th, facing 45 shots in the loss. And Joshua Robbins, who will start tonight. In 2 games, he's 2-0 with a 1.0 goals against average. He has a shutout and a .963 save percentage. We'll take a look at the Southern Illinois University Edwardsville. The Cougars, they are 1-5-1, having lost 6 of the last 7 games, including an overtime loss to Louisville back on September 15th, and a pair of defeats, 4-1 and 6-3 to Illinois State last weekend. The Cougars trailed 2-1 heading into the third game, heading into the third in game 1, but a pair of goals from Avery Bonchek sealed the win for Illinois State. Game 2 was a little bit closer as the Cougars could not use a shorthanded goal from Brendan Somner in the second period to keep the rally going in their loss. This is the 7th and 8th games of 10 games on the road for the Cougars. They have 2 more against Bradley on October 27th and 28th before heading home for 11 of the next 12 games at their home arena, East Alton Ice Arena in Illinois. Take a look at some of the leading players for Southern Illinois Edwardsville. Caleb Harrop is first in scoring with 4 goals and 3 assists and points in 4 of the 7 games he's played. Jacob Schreiber is second, 3 goals, 2 assists, and has a 3-game goal scoring streak and a 4-game point scoring streak. Simon Maxfield, he is third, 2 goals, 3 assists, has a 2-game point scoring streak and points in 4 of the last 5 games. Mentioned Brendan Sommer, he is fourth in points with 3 of the last 6 games played, actually with 3 points in the last 6 games played. They're all goals, all 3 of his. Elijah DeFawcett and Blake Smith are also tied with 3 points, but both have 3 assists each. They are 2 of 12 players to have a point this season for the Cougars. Goaltender Brendan Rush, he lost his last game over the week last weekend, a combined 69 shots against in both of the games that he played. Timothy Barbie played 25 minutes last Saturday with no decision, and he lost against Louisville on September 16th, stopping 37 of 42 shots. I mentioned the goaltenders. So the starting goaltenders for Drury, Josh Robbins, and Robbins, he's 2-0 with a 1.0 goals against average, a .963 save percentage. And in net tonight, it will be Brendan Rash. Rash, 1-4-1 in 6 games, 3.71 goals against average, and a .922 save percentage. Both teams are getting ready to get onto the ice. The Cougars have made their way. The Panthers will here momentarily. We'll take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll tell you about the referees and have on-ice festivities in just a moment.
Pearson Kelly
Office Products presents
Great Moments in Office Technology.
When Julie gets bored at work, she writes funny captions to pictures of animals she found online. Then she realized she could send all of her pictures in one gigantic message to her coworkers. At that moment, Julie created Junk Email. Now, employees can enjoy their days watching auto-tuned sneezing pandas. There are plenty of ways to waste your company's money. Your copier shouldn't be one of them. Pearson Kelly Office Products. Business made simple.
We're back at Jordan Valley Ice Park. Stan, Mel, tonight, Serena. They're about to announce the starting lineups. Let's join the public address announcer.
Public address announcer. Let's welcome to the ice the visiting Cougars. And now the starting lineup for tonight's game for the visiting Cougars. At forward, number 9, Jacob Schreiber. Forward, number 17, Brandon Sommer. Forward, number 85, Caleb Harrop. Defenseman, number 27, Carson Weber. Defenseman, number 92, Cole Quaffender. Goaltender, number 31, Brendan Rush. The Cougars are coached by head coach Tyler Elbricht and assistant coach Jory Skelton. And now, Panthers fans, on your feet, let's meet the starters for your Drury University Panthers. Starting at forward, from Pinson, British Columbia, Canada, number 10, Ethan O'Rourke. Forward, from Tulsa, Oklahoma, number 19, Jacob Holly. Forward from High Prairie, Alberta, Canada, number 81, Keegan Ferguson. Defenseman from Fishers, Indiana, number 5, Hunter Finley. Defenseman from Quebec, Canada, number 13, Francis Young-Menard. Goaltender from Blackie, Alberta, Canada, number 31, Joshua Robbins. The Panthers are joined tonight by 8-year-old Riker Schmidt, a student at St. Agnes Catholic High School and a participant in the Jordan Valley Ice Park Springfield Ice Cubs. The Panthers are led by head coach Jeremy Law and assistant coaches Cliff Cook and Brett Lathan. The Panthers' athletic trainer is Sarah Robinson, and the strength coach is Corey Roy. Tonight's officials are referee David Hill, referee C.J. Ludemeyer, linesman Garrett Limpert. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to continue standing, and gentlemen, remove your caps as we honor America with our national anthem performed tonight by award-winning father-daughter duo and recording artists John Tweed and Sarah Tweedle.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets red, the bombs bursting in air. They proved through the night that our flag was still there.
Star-Spangled Banner yet wave.
Concert, aren't we? Live rendition of the national anthem. Gotta like that. Fresh 15 minutes is on the clock. I know, it's supposed to be 20, Scott, but that's what's on the clock right now. Fresh 15.
Yeah. Fresh 15 of 20.
Yeah.
So,
well, let's hope they change that.
Let's put 20 minutes on.
Yeah, let's hope they change it to 20 minutes.
So some of the staff down in the box down there is very used to youth hockey, years of youth hockey, and it's typical for youth hockey to be 15-minute periods. But this is adult hockey. Collegiate hockey is 20-minute periods.
Yeah, I don't.
And I believe the
now
ref they, is
now
well,
finally, so. Referee David Hill saw that and he said, "Hey, you got to change it." So they've changed it to 20. Here we go. Drury Panthers skate from the left to the right. And from the right to the left, it'll be Southern Illinois, Edwardsville, and the Cougars. Panthers in their white uniforms. And black and red for the Cougars. We are underway in period number one. It'll be the Panthers with possession. Hunter Finley, 1 goal, 3 assists for him this season. Over to the near side. Sent all the way down by Keegan Ferguson. Driven into the near side now as the Panthers swarm all over the Cougars. Ferguson with it, chipped away from him and sent by Caleb Harrop all the way back down into the Drury Panthers zone. Goaltender gets a little bit too close, just Josh Robbins. He gets back into position and we come the other way. Left to right across the line into the Cougars zone. Worked down behind the net. Comes right out. Hawley with a drive and he missed wide. Hawley right up out in front said thank you very much for the pass and he missed it out in front. Puck to the near side. Now swiped at and Jacob Schreiber is able to clear and send it all the way down. Quickly the Panthers catch the Cougars in a line change. Here comes Drury with a drive in and a save as Keegan Ferguson gets the shot and Rash will stop his first shot on net tonight. Another game here tomorrow. Scott, it is so nice. I hate to say it, as much as we love hockey, it's just so nice knowing we only have 2 games this weekend.
It's nice to know that I could be here and actually watch the game and react to it instead of waiting for whatever latency we have with me doing it from home. So.
Oh, I thought it was great. So there is latency.
But if it is, it's minor now that we both have really high-speed internet and stuff. So.
Yeah, we definitely want to thank the rink for setting us up with some great stuff here.
The city of Springfield with that very high-speed internet.
Something I wish I had at home. We get an icing call here. It's sent back down into the Drury, into the ice. 18:35 to go in the period. Scott, I don't know where you live as far as if you'll be able to see the partial solar eclipse tomorrow.
Yep, we're going to be at the house. Unfortunately, we got to travel down to Arkansas if you want to get the ring of fire that's associated with the annular eclipse. But we're going to get, you know, a cool crescent fire.
Yeah, we were hoping to take a look at that. But
weather depending, of course.
Yeah, and to try to get back up here in time. It's probably not going to happen, so best we don't do that.
Well, I think it's going to be 11 or 12 in the afternoon, if I'm not mistaken. So.
Yeah, it's still not enough time. Puck to the near side boards. Here is Drew Paris, sent over to the far side. Kept in by the Panthers, Neil Serrato. Chipped away.
driven back down, and it'll be Smith to take it away. Sent all the way down into the Drury Panther end of the ice.
Still zero shots on goal showing.
Well,
it
should have been one on that one save, but they'll probably catch up with that. Swung all the way around to the near side in the SIUE end. It'll be stopped and given by Luke Kangas. Now a drive that's partially blocked. That came off the shot of Tyler Sillenpah, an original Panther. Puck back behind. Work to the right side. And Simon Maxfield will bring it out to center ice. Two goals, three assists for Maxfield this season. Panthers get the puck. They'll bring it across the line. And Maxfield is there to swipe it away. Third in scoring, two-game point scoring streak for Maxfield. Puck in front of the Drury bench. They'll set it up. 17:02 to go in the period. Puck cleared all the way down to the Cougars' end of the ice. Line change for the Panthers. Keeping it in momentarily was Tyler Kane, and it's cleared back out to center. Panthers, or make that the Cougars touch the puck. Not too many men. They were close, but a couple players jumped off just in time. Nick Garofalo with possession. Pinballs through and goes underneath his stick, so he'll have to set it up again from the far side, but it's intercepted though. Tyler Hutchinson not able to get in control. Panthers do at center and cross their DU logo. All the way down to the corner now for Ethan Keenel. Keenel's pass intercepted. Now right out in front, a drive that's partially blocked as Finley got the shot. Panthers with all sorts of pressure here. It's finally taken away and cleared out to center. 15:58 to go in the period. Puck flipped back in. Garofalo intercepts. Now the Cougars with possession. Brendan Somner. Somner with three goals. He is fourth in scoring, though, believe it or not. Had a goal against Illinois State October 7th. Puck's in all the way in. We get an icing call here. Icing with 15:41 to go in the period. They have now put a shot up on the board for the Panthers. Face off in the Panther end. Josh Robbins, the goaltender. 6'1", 185 at a Blackie, Alberta, Canada. Won his last two starts. Faced a season high 46 shots. Earlier. Puck deflected away. Here come the Cougars. Brendan Somner. Two on two. Somner with a drive right through the crease. It's deflected away. Cleared out to center. Oh, off the boards. Out in front to Ferguson, and it's chipped off of his stick by Weber. Good defensive play there. Stolen once again. O'Rourke. He'll look for a pass, but it hits a skate. Now left side drive into the glove of Rash.
Cougars bench went crazy looking for a offsides. I guess they thought that it was offsides, and it's kind of difficult with only one liney to know for sure. But
yeah, I think I don't know. It's hard to tell. Boy, do I wish we had a replay. We'll get it one of these days. Puck to the near side. It's one of those things that, as soon as the season ended, you kind of looked to see if it worked again, and it didn't work. Puck is flipped up and out of play after the save by Rush, and we will get faceoff. Should stay in the zone. Now three shots officially on the board. In to take the draw, Louis Fournier. And he does not win it, but the Panthers keep possession. Labutis, Patrick gets pushed out of the play, and it's taken away by the Cougars. And Elijah DeFawcett. Panthers momentarily stole the puck, but Blake Smith will take it for the Cougars. Lead pass to Kagan Kruger. Kruger with some trouble, and the Panthers will intercept. 14:16 to go in the period. Devin Gilligan looking for his first points, a sophomore out of San Jose, California. Here come the Panthers. They have a three-on-three into the zone. Pass right back from Fournier. Intercepted, though. Taken away by Drew Paris. Cougars just enough to get it in. They want to go for a line change, and they get that change. With 13:52 to go in the first period and no score. Here are the Panthers with Brady Kangas, freshman, still looking for his first points. Now Luke with it, Luke Kangas. Both Kangas on the line here tonight for Drury. They're brothers. Here come the Panthers across the line. Here's Stegel with a drive in and a pad save. Rebound to the corner. In fact, speaking of Stegel, Gannon Stegel will be our first period intermission guest.
I believe he's a product of Kansas City, if I'm not mistaken.
Plattsburgh up near Kansas City.
Yeah, I think he played for the St. Joe Griffins in his youth hockey days.
Puck is tipped all the way down back into the Drury end. Panthers out of their own zone. Lead pass connects, makes it way to Francis Young-Menard. Actually, take that back. That's 33, not 13. 33, that is Xavier Abel. Abel with it. He's a trivia question answer. Puck comes in, tipped in front, goes behind the net. That one off the stick of Tyler Keane. I don't know. We have boo birds out. Somebody's booing or something. Puck held in. Finley down the middle. Finley's pass is steered aside by Rash. Right out in front, and Rash tries to cover it up, getting pushed in front is Tyler Keane. And do we get anything out of this? Apparently not. Everything's good.
Kane's very dangerous in front of the net there, too, and he makes his presence known.
More like being a pest in front of the goaltender.
Well, that's your job there, though.
Absolutely. So I mentioned that Xavier Abel is the answer to a trivia question, and if the question was who scored the first ever goal in Drury Panther history, that's your answer. Puck sent down. Back behind the net. Drew LaRose tried to get it into the corner. Now chasing it is Jacob Schreiber. He gets pulled out of the play, and he's able to get it up to center. 3-on-1, developing. Here comes Harup with a drive, and he missed wide. Puck out to center ice, so that might be another odd man rush going the other way. Across the line, in for O'Rourke. A drive into the glove as O'Rourke got the shot from the left faceoff circle. And Rash puts his glove out through some traffic. He's able to make the save. And with 11:39 and the clock stopped in the Southern Illinois Edwardsville zone, we get a faceoff. O'Rourke, he'll be the one to win it. O'Rourke down low along the goal line, looking for some help. Gets around the check of Drew LaRose, and the puck is cleared out to center ice. Panthers will set things up in their own blue line. In their own zone, actually, at the blue line. Keenult's pass, intercept, or take that back. It is Caleb Schmidt's pass, 24 from the wrong team there.
No definitive zone presence for the Cougars yet.
Not at all. Here comes DeFawcett looking for a drive. Serrato sticks that into the corner. 10:58 to go in the period. Puck to the far side. Intercepted. Taken by Jacob Hawley. He's able to clear, and that's enough. One can argue the pressure right now has changed a little bit. But the Panthers looking to get something going here. Off the boards. Held in. Here is a nice move by O'Rourke. Out in front. Drive by Hawley is blocked, and we come the other way. Paris. Drew's pass gets deflected up and out of play. Drew Paris, the senior out of Troy, Illinois, looking for his first points. So So there are, and I'm assuming students here, dressed up all in pink. They're on both sides of the rink. As there is a breast cancer awareness event going on, I guess with the students. Here's a drive in, it's blocked in front. Labutis couldn't grab. Fournier tries to poke it away. And it is sent out to center ice by Garofalo. SIUE with a drive in. They go for a partial change to the Cougars. Here come the Panthers, left to right, across the Cougar line, into the zone for the captain, who sends it all the way around, Riley O'Connor. Behind the net now, gets intercepted. Garofalo in to poke through. O'Connor pushes his man. Garofalo gets it out, and it will be the Panthers with Lewis Fournier to grab it. Panthers off the boards. They bring it into the zone, but SIUE with Garofalo. They clear it out. Right side, across the line to Joey Cutts. Gets a centering pass and a deflection. And a good check in front, too. The officials let it go. Puck comes all the way down. No icing. Stopped by Rash. Off the boards. Gets it out to center. Across to Weber. Down low in the Panthers zone. Check applied by Francis Young-Menard. Panthers with possession. Here comes Labutis. His pass comes up to center. Across to Fournier. Centered in front, and they couldn't get it in front to Luke Kangas. Panthers with possession. Maxfield all the way down. This should be an icing call. And no, they wave it off. A drive in off the side is held on to by Robbins. And that's got to be tough when it's sent all the way down, and the official waves off the icing. And we're talking about with authority. We're not talking about a slow roller. And the officials wave it off. Last I heard, there is no hybrid icing, right?
That's not a thing.
So, should have been an ice. Apparently not.
Apparently he thought the Cougars won the race.
8:38 to go in the period. Panthers with possession again. Drop down low, chasing it is Brady Kangas. He gets checked off the play by Blake Smith of the Cougars. Puck held in, a drive missing wide. Now Smith and Kangas are still jawing at each other. Puck is held in, stolen, taken by Luke Kangas. A drive up high, missing. Now behind the net, Brady Kangas is there. It'll go to Stegall. Now left side, Hunter Finley has some room. Finley moves in, passes through, couldn't get it to the other Kangas and Brady. Now Smith will intercept. Three assists for him out of St. Charles, Missouri. Sixth in scoring, had an assist against Illinois State October 7th. Line change and a full sail change for the Panthers.
You could say Kangas got away with one there because that was a clear interference.
Maybe the officials just didn't know which one it was. Puck taken away, flipped out, kicked right back in, a delayed offside, and the Panthers, well, they had everybody cleared and they just dropped it in with no real momentum. Here come the Panthers again with Tisdale. Intercepted briefly. Now Tisdale, left side, up the middle, drive, and it missed wide. It was partially chopped at by Serrato and enough to get through. Now Kane looking for a pass. Good block by Smith of the Cougars. Goes to the far side. Kane with it again. Kane through some traffic. Sends it down. And it'll go to Lourenco. Cody Lourenco centers in front. Oh, what a drive and a miss. Kane was right there in front and he missed it. Panthers had it set up perfectly. Now they steal the puck again. Stolen from Schreiber. But Smith cannot clear it either. Good puck possession by the Panthers. Here's Tisdale centering it up. Left side, a drive in pad. Save as the drive from Ethan O'Rourke is stopped by Rausch.
That is a nice save, too.
But I'm sure O'Rourke would love to have that one back. He was set up so perfectly and just tapped it wide to the right.
Well, when he collected up that puck, that was just enough time for that goaltender to get over and get set.
Shot 7-1 unofficially on the board.
and it doesn't really tell the tale of the pressure either.
Absolutely. It's been all Drury
for
here.
The 14 shots, there's probably been, you know, 20 shot attempts.
Now back behind the net into the corner for O'Rourke. Garofalo can't clear, chipped out and kept in by the Panthers. And that's the thing. They kept so many point shots in. It kept the pressure up. We're going to get a penalty here. It's going to go against SIUE. Oh, it's interference. And are they going to call the Panthers? They are. Gilligan is going to get called for interference. So it is not a penalty against the Cougars. Southern Illinois on the power play, 3 for 12, 25%. Penalty kill for the Panthers, 6 for 24, 75%. Southern Illinois has allowed one shorthanded goal this season. In fact, the only two shorthanded goals for the Panthers are Matthew Teasdale's. Here's a drive in, missed wide from DeFawcett. Up high again, Maxfield. Maxfield looking for a pass, but instead it'll go over to the near side boards. 1:36 remaining in the penalty. DeFawcett looks down from Maxfield. Brought all the way around, intercepted by Finley. Can he clear for the Panthers? No. Kept in. Now it is finally chipped out to center with 1:20 to go on the power play. Oh, puck almost stolen. In fact, it is stolen by the Panthers. But making up for it is Harup, and he's able to come right side across into the Panthers zone. Harup over to the left side, a drive in pad save. That one came off the stick of Joey Cutts into the near side boards. 58 seconds remaining. Behind the net, Finley and Gilligan. Or no, that can't be Gilligan. He's in the box. Have to catch that number in a second. Puck gets flipped up and into the glove of the goaltender. I think it's Francis Young-Menard there, 13, not 3. Line change for both teams. Shot 7-3 now, and still no score. That's one thing that has changed for Drury. In the first four games, they had been outscoring teams as much as 11-0, 11-1. And goals have been few and far between in the last couple of games for the Panthers. 28 seconds remaining in the power play. But again, their top line is the line that has been putting the puck in the net, so to speak, lately. And that's the line of Holly, Ferguson, and O'Rourke, averaging almost 3 points per game.
And all three are top 10 in their division, too.
Absolutely. But with the exception of Patrick Labutis' goal, it's been kind of tough for the Panthers to get any other scoring going on. And yeah, you need that.
And that power play netted two shots on goal for the Cougars.
Here come the Panthers. Drury in the SIUE zone. Brady Kangas tried to control the puck. It's flipped back out to center. Oh, and a couple of Panthers collide. It'll come down in and chasing it. See who that Cougar is. Think that is Connor Hintzer. That name sounds familiar. He's played here before. Played for Missouri State. We're going to get a penalty behind the play. It's going to be called
high stick.
It is a high stick, yes. And it goes against the Panthers once again.
Is that Young-Menard, I think?
I believe so. Second power play now for the Cougars. Here in the first period, Francis Young-Menard gets called. That is just his third penalty this season. So another SIUE power play. left point. Drop down in low. Brendan Sommer fell down. The Panthers trying to move the puck. Still a scrum behind the net. Finley trying to push it. Panthers regain. Now here come the Drury Panthers. They have a two-on-two as they bring it in the zone shorthanded. Fournier with a backhanded pass intercepted by Hara. He'll lead the charge into the Panthers zone. Not much as far as emphasis getting into the zone. We get a whistle for a stoppage and play, I believe. We are going to have the puck flipped out of play. So faceoff stays in the zone. 1:19 to go in the power play. Penalty assessed to Francis Young-Menard for high stick. So 3 for 12 are the Cougars, 25%. But they're 0 for 1 today. Puck with authority cleared. And the Panthers have now 1:04 left to kill. Keenel. Now up across the line into Kruger off of his stick. And taken away as it's cleared, bounced off of the stick in front of one of the Cougars who has the puck now. That was Keenel. 34 seconds remains. 1:49 to go in the period. Still no score. Puck taken away and cleared. It is on goal, had to be played, but it wouldn't have mattered anyway because Panthers are killing a penalty. Panthers steal. Send it back with 9 seconds to go. Cougars with Elliott McAtee. Power play is over. We're back to 5-on-5. Now Drury out of their own zone. They bring a 2-on-3 into the zone. Sillenpah waits for everyone to catch up. He gets pushed from behind. We're going to get a penalty. It's a holding call, and Ethan O'Rourke comes in to protect Sillenpah, but let's just hope it's just one. Check from behind, charge, which is it? It's a holding call. So Connor Hintzer will get called for the penalty. So with less than a minute to go.
1 minute remaining in the period.
Or as he said, 1 minute. The Panthers have a chance to take the lead. Now if they do not score in the next 55.5 seconds, penalty will carry over and there should be about 54 seconds remaining as they start the second period if they do not score here. Ferguson off the draw. Gilligan, or take that back, that is Francis Young-Menard up high. He gets a shot off, it's partially blocked. Goes to Ferguson. And now we're gonna get a whistle. And Scott, I don't know if this is it's a cross check, but I didn't see that in front. Ethan O'Rourke will get called for cross-check. And honestly, I was looking at the play develop and the pass coming across. So apparently he did something the officials didn't like. So now, the penalty will not matter because we're 4-on-4 when we head into the next period, no matter what. Here comes Young-Menard. He'll center it. Goes to Labutis with a drive in and a save by Raj. 21.9 seconds remains. Patrick Labutis, fourth in scoring, had a goal against Maryville a couple of weekends ago, 9:30, September 30th, that is. Points in four of the last six games for him. Abel in to take the draw from Harrop. Panthers don't win it. 19 seconds left. There's Blake Smith. His pass off of Harrop. 10 seconds. Panthers enough to get it into the zone. Maybe one last shot. Young Menard gets pushed into the corner. Or take that back. That's Abel. 33 now with time expiring in the period. And no score after one period of play. Shots on goal. Brendan Rash faces 8. Josh Robbins faces 3. Keep in mind, there will be 1 minute 18 seconds left in the penalty to Ethan O'Rourke, 55 seconds left in the penalty to Connor Hinterser. Penalties, well, there have been a few. 3 penalties, 6 minutes for the Panthers, and 1 penalty, 2 minutes for the Cougars. Panthers are 0 for 1 on the power play. Cougars 0 for 2, but there will be a short power play barring any further scenarios. In 55 seconds when Hinterser comes out, it'll be a short power play because the 118 will still be running on the Panthers' O'Rourke. But no score after one period of play. The Panthers did have a lot of pressure there. In fact, at one point, like you mentioned, Scott, there was about 5 or 6 shots that were at one point in favor of the Panthers, who kept the puck in. You thought it was going to get cleared and just good pressure by Drury, but they could not get anything past the goaltender, Brendan Rash.
Yeah, he's definitely standing on his head today.
Absolutely. We'll take a break, and when we come back, Gannon Stegel will be our guest of the Drury Panthers. We'll do that in just a moment. No score after 20.
Hey, Missouri. Barrel Bob here. I'm MoDOT's Work Zone Spokesbarrel. I see a lot of distracted drivers in work zones not paying attention to the road. Distracted driving is the number one cause of crashes. The average text takes 5 seconds to read. At 55 miles per hour, you could travel the length of a football field blindfolded. Don't take the chance. I want you and my friends working on the roads to get home safely. Please buckle up and put your phone down. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Tri-Lakes Marine started with Pat and Eric working out of the back of their service truck, repairing boats and keeping folks on the water. Today, Tri-Lakes Marine is the largest Yamaha outboard dealer in the state. At Tri-Lakes Marine, you will find in stock Yamaha outboards, G3 aluminum fishing boats, and a full lineup of Suncatcher pontoon boats. And Tri-Lakes Marine is still a full service dealer with a complete Yamaha service center because maintenance matters. We take care of our customers. Check out our full lineup of boats and motors at Tri-Lakes Marine, 15 minutes south of Nixa on Highway 160.
We're back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena. Talking with us now is Gannon Stegel of the Drury Panthers, sophomore defenseman out of Plattsburgh, Missouri. And Gannon, welcome to the team. You have points. You've got 4 assists. Still looking for that first goal. It's eluding you right now.
Yeah, I'm pretty hungry. I think I'm due, though. I think we'll find it, hopefully, soon. Hopefully this weekend. So.
This is right now a team, and I know that everybody has the potential to put the puck in the net, but right now it's a team where it's the line of Holly Ferguson and O'Rourke that's kind of getting the points. How does everyone else feel? Do you guys feel like it'll come?
I think it will come, hopefully when our line can stay in the game. I know our last games we didn't last all, but just shortly into the second. But, no, we've definitely got to step up to the plate and help them out. So, yeah, they've been a huge part of our success for sure.
You guys started out 4-0. Everything looked rosy, scoring 11 goals in 2 games. Do you feel like you kind of got set down to earth a little bit in your games 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, maybe. I think maybe we came in a little too high instead of just finding that happy medium. It was it was good that it happened early on, and hopefully we learn from it moving forward.
You, of course, from Pittsburgh, Missouri, kind of north of here. You kind of had your choice of schools. Why Drury?
That was a shock to me. I was playing baseball at Maple Woods last year, if you will. But I got a phone call late into my redshirt season, actually, and I'd just come off surgery, and Coach Lawsey gave me a shout and gave me an opportunity to play hockey again, and I was more than happy to take it. So
let's discuss that. You're playing baseball. Has baseball been kind of one of your other go-to sports?
Yeah, baseball is actually a primary sport of mine, but it was a little bit easier to come back playing hockey after that surgery than it which that sounds kind of crazy, but no, I had surgery on my labrum there, and that takes a lot of time, a lot of physical therapy.
Sure.
So, yeah, it was a shock.
What position do you play in baseball?
Center field, outfield. But okay. If I could pick center field, I like center field.
So, obviously, you're a defense here. Did you pick defense? Have you always been defense in hockey?
No. I was a forward my whole entire career, if you will, up until my age out year in juniors. And we didn't have enough defensemen. And I told my coach I've always been a center. I kind of know how to do that. I was a quarterback in high school as well, so I see the ice well. And I just tried it for giggles, and I actually ended up liking it a little bit. So I have a little speed that will surprise you on the back end. So
okay, I mean this in a nice way, but as soon as you said that, you look like a quarterback.
Oh, no. That's funny. Yeah, I played quarterback my last 2 years of high school in football, and I think that really helps me see the ice from the back end too. So
sure, that it's all kind of coming together in that respect. Were you – when you got the opportunity to play hockey, were you, I don't want to use the word upset, but I guess what I'm asking is, which do you like better, baseball or hockey?
That's a tough one. Right now, I think baseball would cause me more pain just up until we heal. We, as in my shoulder and I, we're having some difficulties. But no, that's a really hard choice. I don't know if I can give you a straight answer. But it's hockey season right now, so hockey.
And you use different muscles in hockey than mm-hmm. you do in baseball. In baseball, it's kind of above the waist kind of motions with throwing yep. and things like that. But with hockey, it's below that. And you don't have to worry about cherries when you're running the bases nope. or anything like that, right?
Yep.
But isn't, I don't know, isn't hockey, if you compare the two, I mean, okay, which sport is more of a wimp sport? I mean, think about it. I would say hockey is your better sport. But again, I mean, I love both sports too. But if you're comparing and you ask me, which no one does, but if you did,
That one's easy to answer, hockey. Although, I mean, hockey's more tough than baseball, no questions. I think baseball is a different mindset, and that's what's
absolutely
tough to grasp about baseball. Yeah, I don't know if a lot of us, including myself, could hit a 95-mile-an-hour fastball. That's a different mindset than going out here and trying to keep all your teeth in your mouth.
100%. Gannon Stegall is joining us of Drury Panthers. But as a goalie myself, facing 100-mile-an-hour pucks, that's crazy.
No, it definitely – every goalie I've had past high school, there's something off with them. If they're going to stand in there and eat pucks at 90-plus consistently at 30 shots a game, there's something different there too.
Yeah. I've been accused of having a lot off with me, so you know, that's the way it works. Gannon Stegall is our guest of the Drury Panthers. Plattsburgh, Missouri, when you were growing up, were you, what sports, I assume just maybe baseball, you were kind of more consumed with, or did you have hockey in your background?
I didn't have hockey until a little later on, but baseball consumed my life. Really, it still has up until juniors, really. That was the only time I really ever took time to practice hockey. In high school, I played sports year-round, with football, wrestling, basketball, track. I never had time to really focus on one sport. And then I had the opportunity to go and play junior hockey, where that's your life. I mean, all day, two times a day, you're
sure.
skating. So I really developed a lot of my game in juniors, and I saw more opportunities come from that, such as this one as well. I mean, I quit hockey for a whole year, and I was still able to come back and play, and I just thank God that I have that ability, because a lot of people don't. Like, for instance, I'm a 22-year-old sophomore, and really I'm a freshman in terms of eligibility. This
sure.
is I redshirted, so I have 4 years Not a lot of people get that chance, and I just don't want to take that for granted. Like, I got a lot of guys at home who would kill to be in my spot, so I'm kind of, in a way, living their dream out too. So,
speaking of that, as we're talking with Gannon Stegall of the Drury Panthers, what do you want to be when you grow up?
That's a good question, actually. I have an idea of what I think I want to be. I think I want to go into cybersecurity. I'm studying computer science here at Drury. My passion, though, is clothing. I'd really like to get into suits and make my own suit out of Kansas City and name it, like, the Monarch or something. I don't know. I really like clothing. I mean, as you guys would know, hockey, you show up in a suit, it looks clean. So that's probably my passion. That's probably something I'd really like to do.
Okay, so who shows up the best dressed right now?
Oh, that's tough because we haven't even whipped our pea coats out yet. So I think we'll have to wait and see. We've only had 2 games. So
sure.
I know everybody's got more in the bag. They're all holding bags, what they said in the locker room. So.
Okay, so talk to us then as far as a suit goes. What makes a good suit?
Oh, I'd say your confidence in wearing it. I think, for instance, I've got $30 suits. I've got a $500 suit. Some nights my $30 suit looks better than my $500, just the way you walk. So I think what makes a good suit? Your confidence in wearing it.
Gannon Stegall is our guest. Okay, so if that's the case, then are you telling me that my $30 suits, as long as I have confidence and I feel that they look good and I act like it looks good, then that's all I need? There's nothing, if I go to an event, no one's going to look at it and say, that doesn't look good. That's not like a name the suit.
Well, yeah, I mean, unless you're wearing a bunch of different colors that do not coordinate. If let's say you're just wearing a navy suit, white shirt, navy tie. Yeah, I believe if you walk in and you have confidence in what you're wearing, I don't think anybody else's opinion would matter to you. So
I do have a tux, and when I was wearing it before, I gained a little bit of poundage in the stomach area. If I can get rid of that, maybe in like another 5 to 8 pounds, I can fit back in that tux.
Uh-oh.
I'm waiting for that. One of these days, I'm going
to
show
up.
What
you're trying to say is you're the best dressed. Here just comes soon.
No. I'm not trying to say that at all. I'm trying to say that I could fit into one of the better suits that I purchased if I could just lose some weight. I'd be in good shape. Because, you know, for those who may not know, tuxes are form fit. Like, they are right.
Snug.
Snug. Yep. And, yeah. And so I was right on the line with it. And now I know I can't wear it because I got to get rid of just a couple of extra cheesecakes that I ate, you know.
See,
that
and maybe
thing.
Sometimes you don't. You can always go get it readjusted, too.
Ah, okay.
Have
things
them take
I didn't
some
know.
Out of it, yeah. So
maybe you'll be the suit guy to the hockey stars or
that
something.
That would be pretty cool, actually. That'd be really neat.
Kind of be like, what's his name that is the cup keeper, you know? He's just.
Yeah.
He just does it. He got into it, and he does it, and that's his job. Wouldn't that be a great job?
Yeah, I would love that job, personally.
Gannon Stegall is joining us of the Drury Panthers. So do you have any brothers and sisters?
Yeah, I've got 2 brothers. I've got one who's almost 20 here in November. He's actually in Maryville playing baseball right now, Maryville, Missouri, Bearcats. I've got a sister in high school, 15, sophomore. And I've also got another little guy. He's 7, Eli. So
you have a big family.
Yeah, yep.
How many of them play hockey?
It was just my brother, Brock, the 20-year-old. He played hockey up until his senior year and chose to follow baseball. He did a year at State Fair, and now he's in Maryville.
All right, one final question here. You have a chance, and I got to think how this would work. Okay, so you have a chance to go to the Stanley Cup Finals.
Oh, wow.
Or you're in a championship baseball game, or you could go to a championship baseball game. I know the dates don't kind of line up, but let's say you.
So you're saying either the World Series or the Stanley Cup.
Well, but they're not really on the same dates, so I was trying to figure out how this could work. But maybe, I don't know, maybe there's a playoff game because it's around April or May, right? So maybe there's some kind of baseball playoff game or something, or some famous game that you're given a choice to go to. Are you going to the Stanley Cup or are you going to that baseball game?
Ooh, it would have to depend on who is playing who. If the Boston Red Sox are playing, I'm probably not going to watch that game. But if the Yankees were playing, you might persuade me if the Capitals weren't playing in that Stanley Cup game, so, or that playoff game. So that is another difficult question. I've had that question actually a lot, and we talked about it earlier, baseball or hockey. Whichever one will let me play longer. So
there you go. And whichever one has your favorite teams in them, right?
Yeah, that too, as long as they're not the Red Sox.
So we know it's the Yankees and the Capitals, right?
Yep.
Who's your favorite player?
For which team?
Either.
No. Ovechkin. That was an easy one for me. And then for the Yankees, I might have to go throwback here. Either Robinson Cano. That's a loaded question. Probably I'm going to go with Cano. Robinson Cano.
I'll tell you, I'm going to go way back, and I'm going to say Reggie Jackson.
Oh, you're going way, way back. Okay. Fair.
Because I've met him. He's a great guy and all that. But, well, we're out of time. So I wish players at the end of interviews more goals. Let's get that
yeah,
one.
Yeah, let's get that first one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Foaming at the mouth.
Absolutely. Gannon Stegall is our guest. Gannon, thanks so much for doing this. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. We'll take a break. More hockey coming up.
This is Barrel Bob, MoDOT's Work Zone spokesbarrel. You'll be seeing more of me as the weather warms up. Crews will be working on our roads. That means lanes will be closed for construction and maintenance work on our highways. As you approach a work zone, please don't drive distracted. You need to pay attention. I want you and my friends working on the roads so I'll get home safely. Remember, buckle up and put down your phone. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
It's time to drop the puck on the second period. Here's Steve Kasson.
Along with Amari Johnson on camera, Scott Lutzke. Oh, wait. He's not going through. Oh, he's live. He's here. That's why.
Yeah, I don't have a camera set up at my perch here, so.
Yeah. It's good. I'm glad to have you here. It's so funny because people have said to me, are you doing this on your own? I said, no, Scott's doing it. Well, where's Scott? Well, you know, he's not, at home.
He's at home. So it's either you get me on video waving or you get me here talking. And I can tell you I prefer one over the other.
You probably prefer waving. I don't know. It's nice to have a second voice in the booth, though. Now, okay, so they have messed up the scoreboard.
Yes.
Because
they set the timer for the intermission
and didn't isolate
it from the game.
So there's 1:10 left in the penalty to O'Rourke, and okay, we'll go with 56 seconds, but it's really 55, but whatever. And they'll have to change that other penalty to 1:10. And then everything will be fine. They're learning. It's all good. That's what the holdup is here. Still waiting for them. Okay, so they changed it to 1:39.
Interesting.
So there's going to be much more penalty time. Okay, that's what they said. So here we go. Drury skating from the right to the left and SIUE from the left to the right. Panthers are able to clear. In 46 seconds, there will be an extended penalty time for the Panthers, or against the Panthers, that they'll have to kill, meaning. Here comes Fournier, across the line. Fournier, right side, looking to center it. Serrato, drive-in save, rebound into the corner. 4-on-4 for another 26 seconds. Over to the far side. Now shot in with 17 to go until a power play, and that will be the third power play for the Cougars. Puck out with 9, and the Panthers with Fournier having possession across the line. So Drury now shorthanded for 42 seconds, which is a gift at this point. We'll see if the Cougars take advantage of it. They'll drop it down in low. Still no scores are in the second here. Good forechecking pressure by Tyler Kane. And now Serrato with Kane to help, and they clear. Goaltender comes out. That's Rash. Panthers with a drive, or excuse me, the Cougars with a drive in. That one is stopped by Robbins. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Last minute discussion on where they're going to go on the faceoff. Hawley in to take the draw for the Panthers. And Terrence Parabat in to take the draw for SIUE. Delayed offside, puck is cleared, we're back to 5-on-5. So the Cougars could not take advantage of the extended penalty time they were given. Shots are 9-3, that favors Drury, but still no score. And you would think a Panthers team that had been outscoring players. Oh, what a play to keep the puck in Hunter Finley behind his back. But to finish my thought, you would think that a team that scores a lot, 2-1 ratio, could get some goals, and they're not. SIUE with some good pressure here. Panthers trying to get some shots in. Rash has actually been playing very well to keep his Cougars in this game. Not that he wouldn't. He had a .922 save percentage. We're going to get a penalty. And I'm not sure. It's got to be SIUE. Or are we going to have a delayed offside? I think that's what it is. Once again, it's a two referee, one linesman system. The hand was up. But I think it's for a delayed offside. So faceoff will come back in the Panther end of the ice. False faceoff, so we'll do it all again. Drury Panthers coming in at number 35 in the Central. They have not updated or done the rankings for this period yet. So they're 35. The Cougars are number 31 in the Central as of last season. Blast in by Fournier, and it caught Rash up high. Made a shoulder save on that. And that one's a stinger. That one hurts a little bit. .1709 to go in this period. Face off is one and taken by SIUE. They have a 3-on-3 into the zone. Harp with a drive. He partially fanned on it. Into the corner, falling down, trying to clear the puck, was Brendan Somner. And it's back into the SIUE zone. The Panthers chase. They're offside. It's going to be delayed offside until they clear. They do. And now the Cougars cross the line, trying to push his way a Sillenpaw. And he makes the turnover happen. So here come the Panthers. Fournier with the drive in. Puck turns the other way. Drury has to get back. Missing a check was Sillenpaw. Driving it wide was Krueger. Krueger into the boards. Puck out to center. Here comes Serrato, left side. Serrato bumped off the play. Labutis not able to grab, but Stegel will come back, and he'll send it up. Off the stick of Luke Kangas and into the glove of the goaltender, Rash. He'll hold on. Well, 4 minutes and 5 seconds have expired in this period. 15:55 left. Panthers have it. Serrato driving. It's blocked. Now a left side drive missing wide into the corner by Schmitz. We're going to get a penalty, though. This one initially is against SIUE, but we'll see if anything else comes out of it. Now a couple of players pushing and shoving. Sticks are down, gloves are down. Officials now have to race in. Stegel and Maxfield, they're still going at it. Officials trying to separate one of the Kangases. That's Luke Kangas. He's in there with Parabat. And it looks like at least, well, it was going to be a power play, and it's now evened up. Blake Smith goes into the penalty box for the Cougars. And going into the box for the Panthers, Luke Kangas. So we skate even 4-on-4. If you're head coach Jeremy Law, you have to be a little perturbed at that. You're going to get a penalty for a power play, and now it's even up. Panthers have only had one power play in this game. Scott and Samir, did they change the time on the clock? I guess not.
And they just took Kangas' penalty off, and he...
So maybe he got more?
Oh, it's a 5 minute now.
Okay, so now they're changing things here. Blake Smith is assessed a 5 minute major. It'll be interesting to know what these penalties are, because that was the upcoming penalty to Smith.
And the Panthers have five out there, so.
Okay.
Yep.
So apparently the penalty that we thought was going to be 2 minutes is no longer that. As Kangas is in the penalty box still. They just escorted a Panther out. Amari, did you see who they escorted out?
I did not.
Okay, well, we'll listen to find out, but it's a 5 minute major. I'm assuming then that Blake Smith is out. So a 5 minute major for the Panthers, and they can score at will.
Cougars penalty on number two, Blake Smith. 5 minute and game for crosscheck. Also on the Cougars, number 18, Terrence Pervat. A 2 minute minor for roughing. And on Drury, number 25, Luke Kangas, a 2 minute minor penalty for roughing. All penalties were called with 15 minutes, 44 seconds on the.
So what that means is the two cancel out, and all that's right. Left at this case is the 5 minute major. It's five in a game, so 15 minutes in total penalties. And now the Panthers have 4:03 remaining. Francis Young-Menard over to the left side. Now a pot of Young-Menard again. Left side one more time. Trying to work it to O'Connor. Now Young-Menard with a drive in and a save by Rash. He'll hold on. See if I quickly can figure out these penalties here. Four penalties, 19 minutes to the Cougars, including the 15 in penalties. And 4 minutes, or excuse me, four penalties, 8 minutes for the Panthers. See if Drury can get on the board. Still no score. Off the wall. Up high. Here's a shot by Stegel, and it's blocked. Comes back out. Stegel to set it up again. Gets a return pass. Panthers having all sorts of trouble getting into the zone. Here's Serrato. At the line. A drive in by Fournier is deflected away. And we get a whistle. 3:16 to go in the 5-minute major. Face off once again to the right of the goaltender Rash. Panthers win the draw. They keep it in. Serrato with a blast in, pad save. Right on the doorstep was Lorenko. Right side again. Sent all the way around by Fournier. Into the corner to Serrato. Stops it, gives it to Labutis. Return pass is taken away and cleared and sent down. Stegel. Into the zone, now to Ferguson. Right side, Ferguson into the glove of Rash. He'll hold on. .240 to go in the 5-minute major. Almost halfway through, and just two shots for the Panthers. Puck is cleared again. There come the Panthers across the line, kicked in, taken by Sillenpaa behind the net. Tyler with it, looking for some help. Nobody on the right side. Now we're to the left side, working it around Jacob Hawley. Up high again. Young Menard, right side, 2:06 to go on the power play. Young Menard with a drive in, it gets tipped into the corner. 2 minutes to go. Young Menard out in front, right side, drive, and it just missed. Ferguson had a chance there, and he missed it with 1:50 to go. Young Menard up high again, quarterbacking this. He shoots in, and a glove save by Rash. He'll hold on.
Wholesale line change for both teams.
12:28 to go, and if you look back at this, if you're head coach Jeremy Law, you say you had a 5-minute major. And now just three shots on this power play. And you've had possession too. Here's Fournier with a shot, missed wide. Serrato, two goals, one assist for him. Puck to the far side, again to Louis Fournier. Three goals, two assists for Fournier out of Montreal, Quebec. Now we get a whistle for stoppage. They're going to bring the faceoff outside the zone. Fournier fifth in scoring. He does not have any goals in the past two games. But he did have two goals against Marquette back on September 22nd. 12 minutes to go in the second period. Here's a drive-in, big save as Lorenko got it. The rebound followed up, and Fournier's shot is gloved and held onto. So Brendan Rash, the senior out of Maryville, Illinois, really doing what he needs to do. Save percentage-wise, .922. Goals against average coming in at 3.71, and he is perfect at this point. Panthers have the puck again. Young Menard up top. Finley looking around. Hawley comes in. Power play is 50 seconds. Young Menard looking once again to the right side to Ferguson. Now Young Menard, left side, here in front, score! One nothing Panthers, 37 seconds left in the power play. This one will be Hunter Finley's goal, his second power play goal of the season. And his second goal of the season, so both of them have been on the power play. So Drury gets this goal coming at 8:38. Here in the second period. And the Panthers are 1-for-2 on the power play. And they have 30 seconds left on the major. Here coming in is Larenka.
Drury Panthers goal. Scored by number 5, Hunter Finley. Assisting on the play, number 13, Francis Young Menard. And number 81, Keegan Ferguson. Time of the goal, 9:38.
19-3 of the shots. Panthers now with a 5-on-5 scenario as the penalty has expired, but they keep possession. Puck is past the stick of Serrato and it's out to center ice. Panthers in their own zone will have Stegel to step in front of Sumner. Puck to the point, sent out by Larenko. And it's SIUE with possession in their own zone. Quickly, they get it ahead. Panthers in a line change. Here's Harup with a drive in and a save by Robbins. Just the fifth shot on Robbins. That's got to be tough for a goaltender. We're halfway through this hockey game and only facing 5 shots thus far. But it is a 1-0 lead for Drury. They're out shooting Cougars by a count of 21-5. Well, they haven't put it up on the scoreboard yet, Scott. You think that's number 4? Okay.
Yeah, I just added one myself.
All right, 21-4. Then they're faster than I thought. We're going to get a penalty. And it just put up on the board a penalty to Xavier Abel. And I don't know what he did to warrant that. Power play number 4 for the Cougars. We'll hear from the public address announcer as to what happened there. Now 10 minutes to go in the period.
Panthers penalty being served by number 3,
Maxfield scores. Right off the draw, it's 1-1. Maxfield, just 7 seconds in, gets his third goal of the season here in the second period. This one's a power play goal, so they are 1-for-4. 10:05, the time of the goal. Scott, I have no idea what the penalty was, but it's a 1-1 game now.
Cougar score, scored by number 12, Simon Maxfield. Assisting on the goal, number 44, Elijah DeForest, and number 17, Brendan Sommer.
Meanwhile, the Panthers come roaring back. It's a 1-1 game, although they haven't put it up on the scoreboard yet. And here comes SIUE across the line. The captain with a drive in, that's Maxfield. It's taken away and sent all the way down. This is an icing call. .914 to go in the period. Icing will bring it back into the Drury Panthers, into the ice. Power play, 8:38. Finley his second. Young Menard and Ferguson with the assist. 1-0 Panthers. Power play at 10:05. SIUE's Maxfield is third. DeForest and Sumner, or Sommer, that is. And we're tied at 1-1, although they still haven't put it up on the scoreboard. Buck back in the SIUE end. Here come the Panthers, a drive in that's partially blocked. O'Rourke was right on the doorstep. SIUE with a 2-on-2. Drive in, Robbins steers aside on the shot by Hinterser. Now Connor battles for it. Around to Young Menard, to Finley. Panthers get it out, too far, all the way down, and it's Keenel to have control. Panthers able to keep it in, but it delayed offside, so they have to clear the zone. Cougars in the Panthers zone. Kangas goes flying, so does his stick.
Yeah, he was slashed back there, so Cougars got away with 1-2.
Come the other way, across the line. Into the zone is Stegel. Stegel's pass comes to the point, and a shot that's partially blocked. Now, once again, this is the other Kangas, a drive in, or actually Caleb Smith, 24. Now we're going to get a penalty.
Walsh is back there. Cougars goaltender is getting pretty physical himself.
But it is going to be a penalty against Drury. Brady Kangas. We're going to get both. I think they motion for, what are they motion for? Garofalo is going in too, apparently.
And then now he's not.
Okay. Their penalty door is open, so what do we have here? Yeah, he's going in. That's the wrong penalty. Did Robbins get a penalty?
I'm not sure how, because he's in the other crease.
Yeah, so I don't get this. Now, are the officials going to figure this all out here?
Okay.
No, that's not correct either. So I'm not quite sure. They have 31 on the board for Drury, which is Robbins. I don't see how he'd get a penalty. The play was not even in that zone. Now it's taken off. Let's see if they figure this whole thing out.
Kangas is put back
so
up.
Kangas with 2 minutes, and then I would assume Garofalo goes up there for 2 minutes, and we play 4-on-4. Oh, no, they're going to put the goaltender. So I see. So Garofalo's serving.
26, Brady Kangas. 2 minute minor for goalie interference. Cougars penalty called on number 31, Braden Rush, the goalie. A 2 minute minor for roughing.
So that's the call there. So Garofalo was just serving. And we get an icing here. It's times like this when we wish we had a direct feed so we can hear exactly what's going on. Five penalties, 21 minutes for the Cougars. Six penalties, 12 minutes for the Panthers. And we're 4-on-4, 7:20 to go in the period. Pass over to the right side. Oh, getting his feet out from under him is Weber. He also took out a Panther. That was Schmitz. No harm, no foul. And the Panthers across the line. Serrato brings it over to the right side. Looking for Labutis. Has some room. Patrick, shovel over to the left. Serrato, he'll look for some room. 53 seconds left in the 4-on-4. Schmidt, his pass goes through the crease. Labutis to chase, left side. Puck is out to center. Panthers are able to steal. Here's Devin Gilligan out of San Jose, California. Puck across the line, too far for the stick of Riley O'Connor, and a line change for the Panthers. They change at least two. 20 seconds remaining in the coincidentals. Here's a lead. Cougars with it. A drive in that is saved as it was a little loose there, but Schreiber was able to put some pressure on the goaltender Robbins to cover up. 10 seconds remaining in the coincidentals. Line changes finished. Ferguson comes in for the Panthers, and he does win the draw away from Schreiber. But it's SIUE in their own zone to set it up. With a 5-on-5 now, both players go to the bench. In the Cougar zone. Shot comes through. That was partially blocked. Drew LaRose getting that one. Oh, puck stolen. SIUE with possession. Schreiber in the zone. Schreiber works it. Schreiber shoots. Blocker save Robbins. Ferguson. Maxfield. He'll steal for the Cougars. Ferguson able to flip and get it out to center ice. 5:13 to go. In a 1-1 contest. Buxton all the way down. We get no icing. Maxfield made sure of it. Oh, now we're going to get. Oh, we don't get a penalty as Maxfield got dumped behind the net. Puck flipped out. Taken by O'Rourke and sent right back in as Robbins will get it out of harm's way. Out to center. Panthers slowing down a little bit here in this second period. Yeah, they've scored a goal, but SIUE has controlled a lot of this play here in the second.
Yeah, Sillenpah. Definitely taking advantage of the vacuum left by the Panthers' effort.
Sillenpah drops down. Rimmed over to Ferguson. Out to center. Cougars in with a 3-on-3. Keenel with Kruger in front. Tipped away. Here comes O'Rourke. Oh, we're going to get a whistle behind the play, and two players are going to go. Sillenpah will go for the Panthers, and shrugging his shoulders saying, what did I do, is Caden Kruger. It's a slash. I believe slashing for both. So Sillenpah will go for the Panthers and Kruger for the Cougars. Seven penalties, 14 minutes assessed to the Panthers. Six penalties, 23 minutes assessed to the Cougars. So we skate 4-on-4 once again.
So this is a game that you really need to know your zoology.
Yes.
especially in the feline category. I'm not sure what the genus and species is of each of those, but
all I know is Panthers have spots, right?
Tyler Salampa, a 2-minute minor for slashing. Cougars penalty called on number 10, Caden Kruger, 2-minute minor penalty for high stick.
So that's the call, slashing and high stick, apparently. Tisdale sends it across right side, a drive in, stick save on the shot by Ferguson. We come the other way into the Panther zone, and we get a offside, apparently. Now to bring it outside the zone. 1:17 to go in the coincidental penalties. Shots 23-8 in favor of the Drury Panthers, and we're still tied 1-1. Panthers 4-2 this season. Southern Illinois, Edwardsville 1-5-1, and now we get a whistle. We're moving the faceoff, apparently. Draw one here in front. Abel drive in, and a big save as Abel breaks free off the draw. And Xavier, the sophomore out of Oak Park, Illinois, looking for his first point this season. So face off again to the right of the goaltender. Rash, and out the draw, it is sent all the way down for another icing call. These same two teams tomorrow will have it for you 6 p.m. Central Time, right here on Web Sports Radio. Appreciate you tuning in. .304 to go. Play at the line, a couple of players fall down. That was Maxwell, and the one who has the puck, Fournier, with a drive-in score! It'll be a 4-on-4 goal. Drury takes the lead once again on Louis Fournier's fourth goal of the season. Two to one Panthers, this goal coming at 17:11 here in the second period. There's 45 seconds left in the 4-on-4.
Drury Panthers goal scored by number 76, Louis Fournier. Assisting on the goal, number 33, Xavier Abel.
Well, it looks like we're not going to get a time, but we know it's 17:11, the time of the goal. Puck all the way down in the SIUE zone. Down low for some pressure. Panthers do steal, although it went through a drop stick. We're back to 5-on-5. Here's a blast in, missing wide by Serrato. Still in paw to the bench. Coming out is the man who just almost stole the puck, Gannon Stegall, and we come the other way. Flipped all the way down into the Panthers zone. Behind the net. Kruger gets checked there by Schmitz. Panthers steal. Holly as SIUE gets a chance to change. Serrato's pass, dangerous. It goes right back in front of the net. And Robbins tried to keep it out. Cougars steal. Panthers change. Puck rolls all the way down. No icing. Gilligan. Sillenpaw. Now a minute left. Stegel brings it in across the line. Too far for Abel. We come the other way. Puck flipped down. Actually, no, that was Luke Kangas who missed it. Puck up the middle. McAtee had it go off his stick, and McAtee will chase. Sillenpaw. He gets poked away from McAtee. McAtee takes a check and another one, and this one's going to be a penalty.
Yeah, you got away with the first one. That was probably clean, but the second one was... It was not a good thing to do.
Luke Kangas will go.
And the Cougar just needs to skate away.
Yeah, absolutely. There's no arguing here. Luke is saying, well, look what he did. The officials say, I don't care what he did. I saw what you did. Eight penalty, 16 minutes. Fifth power play for the Cougars now.
And I would say none of these penalties that the Panthers are taking are sensical. They're not going to help you.
No, not at all.
Number 25, Luke Kangas. A 2-minute minor penalty for roughing.
That's going to be the call. Panthers in across the line, chipped away by Gilligan as Sommer was trying to get position. Now the Panthers have it again. 7 seconds to go in the period. This should carry over into the third period. Sillenpaw, is he able to clear? Well, it didn't matter. The time has expired. 1:28 will be left in the penalty to kill on Luke Kangas' penalty. Goals in that period, all three. Power play. Drury at 8:38, Finley his second, Young Menard and Ferguson, it's 1-0. 10:05 on the power play, Maxfield his third for SIUE, DeForest and Sommer. It is a 1-1 game. And then at 17:11 on a 4-on-4, Fournier will get the assist, or excuse me, he'll get the goal. His fourth of the season. Abel will get the assist. 2-1 is where we stand right now. Shots on goal in the second period. 5 on Robbins, 2-period total of 8. And a 2-period total of 26 on Rash. Power plays, Panthers 1-for-2, Cougars 1-for-5, and 2-1 is where we are at the end of one period of play. So we will take a break, and Scott, did you catch the time? I know I said it earlier. I didn't catch the time, but it's running off the clock again. So.
Yeah, I have it. It's 1:28.
1:28. Okay. So
yes.
Remember that. 1:28 remaining in the penalty. We'll take a break. After 40 minutes of play, it's a 2-1 lead for the Drury Panthers.
Kelly Office Products presents
Great Moments in Office Technology. When Julie gets bored at work, she writes funny captions to pictures of animals she found online. Then she realized she could send all of her pictures in one gigantic message to her coworkers. At that moment, Julie created Junk Email. Now, employees can enjoy their days watching auto-tuned sneezing pandas. There are plenty of ways to waste your company's money. Your copier shouldn't be one of them. Pearson Kelly Office Products. Business made simple.
We're back at Jordan Valley Ice Park. Stan Melton, Ice Arena. Joining us is goaltender Josh Robbins out of Blackie, Alberta, Canada. 6'1", 185. 2-0 on the season. 1.0 goals against average. You must like that.
Yes, sir.
And a 963 save percentage. So you're one of three, younger, but, you know, you're all freshmen. But three goaltenders that can play at any given time. You all have wins. How important is it for you to start off the way you've been starting off?
I think that first game this year, it was a really big, and obviously it was the first game. We had to come out, make sure that we set the pace for the whole year. And obviously coming out, getting that first start, it was a really great feeling to be entrusted by the team like that. And game couldn't have gone any better. Pulled out with a shutout with the boys. Everything went good. The whole team stuck around, and everyone fought through. Like, as a whole team, it was really all well put together. And I think we just need to kind of carry that throughout the next games and get it working.
Goaltender, obviously, you build your team around the goaltender. You start with him first. I mean, unless you got some superstar that you want to pick first, right? But it's usually your goaltender. And so to be able to do that, I'm a goaltender myself, so, you know, what I focus on is that first shot. Like, if I can make that first save, everything's golden after that. Do you feel the same way?
I feel like, yeah. I mean, the first save is always the biggest one. But I personally, like, if I think about things a little bit too much, I get in the game a little too hard, and I just start making mistakes. So I like to keep it light and breezy in the net. That's what I always say. Don't focus on anything too hard, and then kind of just get in that state, you know, and you're just making it, letting your body do decisions for you.
Yeah, I know what that's like. I'm kind of the same way. If you get into your head too much, next thing you know is a couple goals past you. And I mean, if it's men's league, it's no big deal because they can't trade me or pull me out or anything. But, you know, there's three here. They could pull someone out.
Yeah, exactly.
Or depending on who's dressed, sometimes three is dressed, sometimes two are dressed. But, yeah, it's got to be tough. But knowing that the team instills confidence, that's obviously a big deal, right?
Yeah, it's a big deal to have the team kind of back you a little bit. I mean, a goalie can come in the net and be confident all itself, but if the team's not confident in the goalie, I mean, it's destined for failure, really.
Josh Robbins is joining us of the Drury Panthers. So why did you pick Drury?
I picked Drury to come down here mainly for the academics. The school program was just starting up last year, and I got an opportunity to come down and be a part of the first team and get that going. And I think, like I said before, the academics was really the main part for me. It's a great school. The courses are all awesome. Teachers are great. And really, in the end of it, we're here to get an education. Hockey's kind of just a ride along the way, but it's obviously fun to be on the team and make the team progress along the way. I guess that's how you'd say it. But be a part of something a little bit bigger than yourself. Just get the stepping stones of the team.
Different coaching scenario now. You feel like you got to work a little harder?
I personally don't work any harder than I did last year. I always work, give it 110% effort, okay, no matter what. Don't really care who's on the ice. I mean, there's really no other way to do it, personally, how I see it.
That's a fair enough answer. I like that. It's a good answer, too. Josh Robbins is joining us of the Drury Panthers, goaltender. So you weren't around, and I'm dating myself a little bit, but I played when pads were 12 inches wide. Now they're 11.
They are a little bit thinner.
So have you ever played in the 12-inch wide pads?
I never have played in the 12-inch pads. When I was young, I had the little skinny ones for the youth pads, and then once I made that bump up to the senior gear, I was already past there.
Yeah, it's kind of tough. I don't know which I like better. I just know that for some strange reason, I have a bigger five hole. I want to ask you this question, but if anybody's listening, I don't want them to figure it out. But do you feel like you have any weaknesses?
I don't know. Like, kind of just depends on the situation, really. As a goaltender, I mean, we've been doing goalie lessons. I've been doing it my whole life.
Sure.
So really, I mean, you have a toolbox of all these different situations, and you can pull something out of it whenever you need to. But it's also situational. I mean, depending on different plays, where the players are, it all depends.
Josh Robbins is joining us of the Drury Panthers. So was goalie always your position?
Yeah, I mean, back when I first started playing hockey, we started out doing the swapping positions. Everyone would play a little bit of everything. I played forward a couple times, played defense a couple times. It's absolutely useless out there. I went in the net and I just made a glove save, and I just stayed in the net ever since I made that glove save. So
it's funny because I was kind of the same way, except for me, I wanted to play forward, but I found out for some strange reason I skated backwards so much better than I skated forward. And because I thought, well, I'll be a defenseman, but then I thought, no, I think I want to be a goaltender. And I got in there, I just loved it, and I've been that ever since.
Yeah, I personally think goaltending is the best position. I mean, some days I feel like I could score a goal, but I want to be a little bit more offensive, but I guess I can kind of take that on the play a little bit. I like to play the puck quite a bit, get a little bit outside of the net and do a little bit of different stuff, act like a D-man every once in a while. Sometimes it doesn't quite go to plan, but most of the time it works out.
They say goaltenders are crazy or they're not in their right mind. Do you take offense to that? Because sometimes I do, but sometimes I realize, oh, people are right.
I think there's a little bit of truth to that statement. It depends on the day. I mean, every once in a while you take a look in the mirror and you're like, wow, maybe they are right. Like, I don't know why I'm taking slap shots from the hash marks some days.
Sure.
But here we are.
Josh Robbins, goaltender for the Drury Panthers, joining us. Who is your favorite NHL player?
My go-to has always been Carey Price. He's a goaltender back in my days. I always looked up to him. He's just his style, the way he moves, everything. I just loved how calm he was in that. And yeah, he's a guy I always looked up to.
Jonathan Quick was always my guy.
Yep.
But if I want to date myself, Grant Fuhr, because I'm a what they call a full right or a southpaw.
Yep.
So Grant Fuhr was my guy.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, I feel like I'm kind of more of a hybrid. You know, it's butterfly now. It's lower work. But for me, I was kind of a hybrid semi-stand-up but still got down low,
mm-hmm.
partially because I just got tired of having to stand back up, you know. But so those were my two go-tos.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. I mean, how it transitions from stand-up goalie to hybrid goalie to butterfly goalie. I mean, it's throughout the years, it's really just shifted more towards the lower end of the net. But, I mean, then the players just shoot it up high. So, I mean, I feel like you can't really always be a butterfly goalie sometimes in the right situation. I mean, there's a shot from the blue line, it's going foot over the net. There's no point in going down, right? Just stand up and make it out of your chest.
But even now, goaltenders, it was just, okay, they can't skate, so stick them in the net. But now you, as a goaltender, almost have to be the best conditioned player on the team.
Yeah, sometimes you got to. I mean, if they're hemmed in your own end for 2 minutes or whatever on a power play, I mean, players are – they have a little bit more time to move around, but I mean, if they're passing all around the ice and they're really just trying to work the outsides, it gets pretty tiring doing T pushes back and forth for 2 minutes.
I mean, okay, so you clear the puck maybe as far as the other blue line. By the time they get it back in, you can change, you being the team, you know, might be able to change a defenseman or a forward or something, not the goalie.
No, you kind of just have to suck it up and make the next save, really.
Absolutely. So do you remember a game that is something that will stick in your mind, something that you did?
Like the first one that comes to mind was probably my first junior shutout. That was a game we played in Victoria down in the Q Center. That was a big game for me. It was great because I was the third goalie for the BCHL team there, and a bunch of guys from that team came down to watch the game as well. And that was actually my first shutout in juniors. It was a big game. It was awesome. A game we really shouldn't have won. The team is way better than us, but I just stood on my head that night. It was awesome.
They say goalies are in the zone, and it's just so weird because once you feel the zone, I feel something had to happen to get into that zone. And it could be something as simple as your skate fit right, or, you know, you strap your pad a certain way, and all of a sudden everything just fell into place. Do you feel the same thing?
Yeah, I agree. It's like sometimes you show up to the rink and everything just kind of falls into place and it just works out. Like, you just get a feeling that it's all going to go good, and it's kind of hard to, like, get in that state. It kind of just happens. But personally, I mean, I like to go, like, during my warm-up, do some ball work, and then I do some stretches, and I just like to calm my mind a little bit. Like, lay on the ground, play some music, and just slow down. I find that works the best to kind of figure it out and get into the right mindset. But obviously, some days it just doesn't work out if you're not in it.
Goaltender Josh Robbins is our guest. Kind of like the first game of the season, everything kind of went well.
Yeah, that game, I mean, I came into it. I was obviously first game of the season, so I was ecstatic to start that game. That was the game I wanted to start first season. Obviously, it was great. And I went in, did my warm-up and everything, and got on the ice, and it just felt right. And playing throughout the periods, every save just felt like just normal. Nothing was too hard to make. It was just there.
Who's your favorite NHL team?
That's a tough question. I don't really have a favorite NHL team, honestly. I kind of just float around. There's a group I play with in the summers of 10, 15 NHL guys, so I kind of just float around wherever
really?
They go.
Really? Drop some names here.
Jordan Eberle, Dryden Hunt, those are a couple guys down there. Austin Wagner, there's a few of them all over the place, but played with probably 10 guys from different teams in the NHL. It's pretty neat experience to go down there and just take some shots in the summer. I mean, really, I just go down and be a shooter tutor for them. So I'm not doing drills or anything. I'm just standing in the net taking shots. But it's pretty neat to see the releases and deal with the speed and everything and the decision making at that level. It's pretty interesting.
So you've got some connections down there.
A few every once in a while. Got to have some, right?
Well, one of the connections that I had was growing up in Southern California. I worked with the LA Kings.
Yep.
And so I was one of their practice goalies.
Oh, yeah.
When I was younger and actually could play a lot better than I can now. And I remember taking a slap shot from Rob Blake, and it went in the hand, in the palm, the web. It wasn't in the web. It was more in the palm of my hand. It hurt. And he just wound up like it was no big deal. And it hurt so bad.
Yep.
And I'm thinking, how do guys deal with pucks that hurt, especially if they get underneath your equipment? You know, how do you deal with that? It's crazy.
Yeah, the glove stingers are a whole different world. I mean, there's like different gloves and stuff they make, like the practice gloves and whatever, with different stiffness and padding in them. Like I run a practice glove and a game glove just so like in practice I don't get any stingers, a little extra padding. But yeah, some of those shots that they take, like I remember I took a slap shot one, hit me like square in the head, and it blew every single buckle on my helmet off.
Oh,
like,
that's crazy.
Every single buckle came right off. It just fell right off.
Bell ringer, I assume.
It was, yeah.
For a while there. Yeah, I've had that too. We played in the Kings had a league that we would play in. And so sometimes like guys like Jim Fox and I think Jay Wells came down. I know I'm dating myself, but he played and just for a little bit. I gotta tell you, that's just crazy. But you know what was great? And one last thing I want to talk about real quick here is how important is it to trust your defense?
I think it's kind of a fine line, personally. I like my defense to not so much do like what they know to do, but I kind of like to guide them around. Like, if they listen to me, that's fine.
Sure.
I'll have full faith in them as long as they listen to me. Like, if I tell them to take the back door and they take the back door, awesome, got that covered. It's my favorite feeling is when they do what I say. And I don't know, like I can see more of the ice than them sometimes. Sometimes they can see more than I do.
Sure.
But in some situations, they got my back, I got their back. But it all works out as a really good harmony.
So it works both ways, absolutely.
It does work both ways for sure.
Josh Robbins is our guest goaltender for the Drury Panthers. We could go on and make another segment out of this, but there's more hockey to play. So at the end of interviews, I always wish players more goals. In this case, no more goals. Let's get the goose eggs.
For sure.
Thank you very much. Thanks for doing this. That is Josh Robbins of the Drury Panthers. We'll take a break. More hockey coming up.
Trilex Marine has upped its game. Not only is Trilex Marine the largest Yamaha outboard dealer in the state with G3 aluminum fishing boats and a full lineup of Suncatcher pontoon boats, Trilex is now the area's newest and largest Bennington dealer. Bennington pontoons are the pinnacle of luxury pontoon boats, and Trilex Marine has several models in stock. If you're ready to up your game on the lake, stop by Trilex Marine today on your way to Table Rock, just 15 minutes south of Nixa on Highway 160, your full-service boat and motor dealer.
Let's head for the third period. Here's Steve Kasson.
Along with Scott Lutzky, who's in-house tonight, and Amari Johnson doing fantastic camera work. Also, check us out on TikTok. That's all Amari's work, too. Amari, I know that you've got a couple more coming up. You had the one. How many more you got?
Oh, I got plenty more. Maybe we'll get another one tonight.
All right, sounds good. I'll hold you to it. Here we go for the third period. Now remember, a minute 28 that is left in the penalty to Xavier Abel. So a shorthanded scenario for the Panthers, and immediately they clear the puck. Sent all the way down where Brendan Rash will stop at senior 6'3", 190 out of Maryville, Illinois. Came into today's game with a .922 save percentage. Robbins has a .963 save percentage. The reason why we have such a low scoring game right now. SIUE, drive by Harrop, misses wide. Harrop, first in scoring this season for the Cougars. Now here comes Teasdale for the Panthers, of Drury. Teasdale thinks better of it, and the Panthers will set it up. They're killing 36 more seconds of a penalty. Pass did not clear, it was gloved by Sommer. He'll bring it in, a drive that is blocked, came off of Schreiber. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Still a 2-1 game for the Panthers. Power play, Findlay. Fournier with the other one, sandwiched in between Maxville's power play goal. Here come the Panthers, 2-on-1. Now right side in front, oh what a save is the pass. Had to be corralled by Tyler Kane, and a good save in front by Rash. We're now back to 5-on-5. Young Menard comes in, he gets pulled off the play. Left side, drive in, pad save, that one came from Ferguson. Out in front as Young Menard was right there, but Rash will cover it up. 18-14 to go here in this third period. Still a 2-1 game. So Scott, one of the laughs that your wife and I was talking about at intermission is, I thought the game's been going fast. I texted my wife and I said, hey, this game's going pretty fast. Your wife said, no, it seems to be going slower. And I look up and I'm like, yeah, when you kind of think about it, maybe it is going a little slow. Yeah. I don't know.
Time's a perspective thing, so.
It definitely is. Good save there. That's a good thing as Robbins steers it aside. We come the other way for the Panthers. Across the line, O'Rourke right side. He shoots, pad save. And Rash has just been in every position to make a save now. 17-49, here's a backhander in. Good save there by Robbins. Steered aside, puck up the middle. Panthers have it. They have another 2-on-1 if they hurry. Across the line. Now O'Rourke passes in front. Oh, what a drive. And what a save as Ferguson got the pass from O'Rourke. And a good glove save by Rash on the 2-on-1 attempt there.
Rash again standing on his head. He's really keeping the Cougars in this game.
Absolutely. He's been in position. He's done what he needs to do.
Now we're just in the beginning part of the third period. And the Cougars finally eclipsed 10 shots on goal. But that doesn't really indicate the danger at all, because
2-1 is the worst lead hockey.
Yeah.
Now here comes the 2-on-1. Speaking of that, here's a drive in, steered into the corner off the stick of Hinterser. We come the other way. I want a big thank you to Connor's mom, who's here. Brought me some Halloween candy. Of course, there is a relation between all of that, because the general manager for the Missouri State Ice Bears is Ryan Armstrong, and that's Connor Hinterser is his cousin. His mom and Connor's mom are sisters. So, but big thank you for some Halloween candy that I was munching on earlier. Drive in, pad save as Stegel got that. Swung all the way around and back out, and the Panthers will have to come back onside as getting hit was Fournier. We come the other way. Drive in, steered aside by Robbins. SIUE with some life now. They're starting to hit. They're starting to get some advantages over the Panthers.
Goaltenders on both ends are doing a really good job of keeping that puck out.
Absolutely, and I mentioned the save percentage, .963 for Robbins, .922 for Rash. And whenever you get above 900, you're going to see some good saves. And that's what's happening, regardless of the goals against average.
And ultimately, that's what a coach wants is 900.
Absolutely.
You're doing your job, because you can stop the first one and the second one, and then there's a third shot and a fourth shot. It's the defense needs to be stepping up at those points.
So. Absolutely. That's why the goals against average really doesn't matter to a goaltender, as long as your save percentage is there. And the goals against average for Rash is 3.71. Sillenpaw, not able to grab it. Comes up top. Here is a drive in front that's blocked. Came off the stick of the man that's chasing the puck back in his own zone right now, and Drew LaRose. Sent all the way back around, down into the Panthers' end of the ice. Nobody really established anything right now. With 15:14 to go in the period. Puck up the middle, here's some room. LaRose score! It's 2-2. Second goal of the season for Drew LaRose. And it's a 2-2 game. And SIUE with only their 11th shot has tied this game.
Scored by number 26, Drew LaRose. Assisted by number 85, Caleb Harup. And number 33, Joey Kutz. Time of the goal, 4:52.
.412 is actually the time of the goal. LaRose from Harup and Kutz. And it's a 2-2 game. And SIUE coming right back in. And that goal has eclipsed the goals against average for Robbins. Here's a drive in by Ferguson, and it's covered up and held onto by Rash. Coming into today's game, Josh Robbins was 2-0 with one shutout. Only had two goals against and a 1.0 goals against average. He's given up two here today or tonight. Fournier comes in. He'll take the draw for the Panthers. DeFawcett in for the Cougars, but the Panthers do gain possession. This is going to be a hand pass. Yes, it is. .1406 to go in the period. In a 2-2 game. Sent all the way around by Weber, held in by the Panthers, in on goal. That'll be another save as Labutis gets one. Stolen. O'Connor has it. He shoots in, glove save again by Rash. He'll hold on. So once again, another face-off in the Cougars' end of the ice. Harup comes in for the Cougars, and for the Drury Panthers, it'll be Fournier, who got a goal earlier to give a 2-1 lead. Now left side, Serrato drive. It's blockered into the corner. Takes a weird bounce up the middle in front, getting pushed as Labutis. Kept in for O'Connor, that is. Riley O'Connor. The puck gets flipped up and out of play, but O'Connor, 10th in scoring. He does have a one-game assist streak. One goal, three assists for him out of East Grand Rapids, Michigan. Abel comes in to take the draw, and he tries to win it from Harup. Into the near side, Connor Hintgesser. Now to Abel, he'll work it around. Abel slides down, battle for it behind the net. Intensity picking up, Abel steals, looking for help. Abel with it, rims it around to the far side. Abel with it again, lets it go to the near side boards. Taken away by Hintgesser, cleared. Does he connect with Harup? It's all the way down, no icing. Puck centered right through, and it'll be taken by the Panthers. Gannon Stegel. Line change for SIUE, they get two off. Now the Panthers. They want to change also. So Abel will wait and set things up once again. 12:32 to go in the period. Pass deflected, taken away. Cole Quatlander on the ice now. Puck almost stolen by the Panthers. It's out to center. Left side, Harup. 4 goals, 3 assists for the junior. Drive in. Another pad save by Robbins. Shots 34-14. We came into the period at 26-8. So both teams getting some looks this time. Now here's a drop back pass, missing wide as Stegel got the shot of the drop back pass from Kane. We're gonna go whistle and a stoppage in play. And it looks like a tripping call. And going on the power play with a chance to take the lead once again are the Panthers, as Simon Maxfield will go into the penalty box. Maxfield's the third leading scorer for the team. Seven penalties, 25 minutes. Power play number 3 for the Panthers. And a 2-2 game here in the third period. Puck up the middle, and just fanning on it was Holly. Looks at a stick and says, I can't believe I fanned on that one. Oh, goaltender Robbins having some trouble, but they does get the puck over to his defense. And here come the Panthers across the line to Finley. He looks over to the left side, connects with Young Menard. Now left side drive and a save. As we get some pushing and shoving in front. That one by Finley. The officials say play on, no penalties here. 1:21 left in the power play. The Panthers coming into today's game 12 for 32, 37.5%. Whereas the Cougars only 70% on the penalty kill. So numbers should say something, but earlier, if you remember, the Panthers had a 5-minute major. They scored one goal late. Ferguson up top, shot, save, as O'Rourke was on the doorstep. Young Menard got it. He likes the perch up high. We'll do it again from the left side. Rash's right side, and Panthers win it again. Young Menard to crisscross. Now they go up top, trying to look for Ferguson. Again to Ferguson. Touch pass to Finley. Now right in front to Hawley. Backhanded through, nobody there. Power play for 47 seconds. Shot deflected. Gets it over to Finley again. This time, a pass comes out in front. O'Rourke shot, save, rebound. It's loose, Ferguson's pass. And it's controlled by Finley again. Young Menard, now to Finley, down in low. Power play has 25 seconds for the Panthers. They're trying to take the lead. Tied 2-2, Young Menard, crisscross. Young Menard shot, save, rebound, held in. Young Menard again. Young Menard has some room, he shoots, save by Rash. Rebound into the corner to Ferguson. 8 seconds on the power play. Here comes Young Menard with some room. Good deflection as it was tipped away by Weber. Power play is over. Pressure by the Panthers comes right out in front. And it's covered by Rash. So the Panthers 1 for 3 on the power play. Descondent during the break there. As we get a shot that comes in, good save by Rash, rebound. Remind me to tell you about something. A shot in and hit mask, the mask of Rash. He didn't know it was there. Here's another drive in from the right side, and Rash will hold on to this one. I saw you rocking out there for a second to the tunes. Up where we are now, they used to have live bands. They can't do it anymore because we're up here.
Yeah, I remember seeing that a couple of times.
Yep. I mean, they could still come up here, but they would blow us out of the water.
No, it's all right. I'd listen.
But here's a drive in just missing wide as O'Connor shot it wide. 9:22 to go. Panthers now all of a sudden have some good pressure. Comes up to Serrato. Left side. Oh, and here might be a potential break as coming in is Parabat. Goaltender sweeps it away. Panthers still trying to get control. Maxfield's in there to push for SIUE. Drop down in low by LaRose. He got the game tire. Shot comes in and a just missing wide as the puck was poked away by Robbins. And right out in front, LaRose just missed wide. Or take that back, that's not LaRose, as he's the one here putting defense on. That was Cutts who got that last shot, number 33. So with the stoppage, faceoff will be in the SIUE end. 41-14 of the shots, and we're still 2-2. Abel in to take the draw. DeFawcett for SIUE. Panthers do gain control. They'll drop it down in low. Abel pass in front. Oh, and just missing through the crease was Gannon Stegel. He was behind the goaltender and he missed right through. Oh, falling down is Sillenpaw, but Panthers are able to clear just in time. Dylan Paul able to clear it again. Panthers cross the line into the zone. Here comes Abel. He shoots in. Save. Oh, Garofalo just threw a punch to Stegel. Apparently the official who looked right at it said it's not warranted of a penalty. Eight minutes to go in the period. Parbat in to take the draw from O'Rourke, but it's the Panthers with the win. Cross ice, drive in, score! Hunter Finley. Rash did not see the shot. The cross ice pass made it along the line. And Finley will get the blast off. Young Menard will get an assist. And it is 3-2 in favor of Drury. 12:09 the time of the goal here in the third period.
Drury Panthers goal, scored by number 5, Hunter Finley. Assisted by number 13, Francis Young Menard. And number 81, Keegan Ferguson.
The 12:09 the time of the goal, Finley with his second of the game, third of the season. Young Menard and Ferguson, as you heard, with the assist. 3-2 Drury. 7:30 to go in the period. Finley brings it down in low. Lorenko sends it through, and you can feel the momentum shift. It's been Drury now in this third period. Keeping it in is Kane. Cougars with it. Lead pass to Harrop. drive in, and it's held on to by Robbins. With 7:05 to go in the period. Shots 43-15. Scott, you still need to get your jury sweatshirt. I'm wearing mine, and I'm still cold.
Yes, I didn't bring a jacket because I thought I had one.
You do, as the shot comes in, and right there on the doorstep is Fournier to try the second effort, and it didn't go in. We'll have to make sure we get it for you.
Yeah, I talked to Cliff already, so I'm good.
There you go. Here comes O'Connor. He shoots, and he went right through the crease. It went off of Rash's goal stick and did tip wide. Here's Weber. He'll have it left, or rank that right to left. Across the line, Weber gets taken out of the play. Officials say keep going. So we do. Here's Labutis. Lead pass. Breaking in and getting pulled down, and we should get a penalty here. And I wouldn't be surprised if we get a penalty shot, but I doubt it. Well, let's see what the officials are going to call. And the only reason I say that is that it's a scoring opportunity. It's one thing to check the guy, but it's a scoring opportunity, and they're not going to call anything.
Yeah, that's interesting.
So nothing is called on pretty much a step and a break. Here's a drive-in save, Rash. That one came off of O'Rourke and into the corner, and it's out to center and all the way down. I'm not sure what you have to do to earn a penalty, or at least draw one.
Well, the Panthers have shown that a few times tonight, so.
Yeah, here's O'Rourke missing wide. Over to the far side, rimmed all the way around. Gilligan, it'll be sent out. Gilligan will chase. 5:40 to go. Puck is stolen, comes right in, and Robbins will hold. How do we get here? 3-2. Drury, power play, Finley. In the second period, 8:38. Maxfield ties it up, power play for SIUE, 10:05 of the second. 17:11 of the second, Fournier makes it a 2-1 game. In the third, at 4:12, LaRose, his second. And then Drury with Finley, his second of the game at 17:09. And that's where we are right now with a 3-2 game.
47 shots. On Rash.
Drive in, held on to once again by Rash.
Robbins.
Oh yeah, Robbins. You said Rash, and you said 37, but I see 47 up there.
And I said 47.
Okay.
Three goals on 47. Or maybe I didn't.
My mind heard you say, it's all good. Here is a potential shot by Maxfield that is stopped. 5:15 to go in the period. 3-2 lead for Drury. These same two teams tomorrow, 6 o'clock Central Time, will have it for you. If you looked at the shots, you would think the score is completely different on a 47-18 shot total, but it is not. It's 3-2. It's the worst lead in hockey. Puck into the corner. Panthers trying to work it. They bring it out. And we are in the final five, brought to you by Cadence Insurance. To the corner. Panthers drop it down low. They'll work it near side. Lorenko's pass does make it through. A drive-in pad save. Coming from the stick, from the right point of the man who has it now. That's Stegall, a drive-in save, and Tisdale just tipped it wide. Or Schmitz, actually, was the one that got the shot, 24. Now the Panthers again. Serato trying to take a two-goal advantage here. Tisdale to Serato. Up top, left side, partially fanned on. They make it to Serato. He'll work it with 4:13. Serrato's shot as Lorenko is running on the doorstep. It missed wide. Teasdale again. Sticks go high. Kept in. Here is O'Rourke with a shot. Blocker save. Rebound. Where is it? It pinballs, but it stays in. Good pressure by Drury. Serrato. He shoots in. It's blocked up front. Taken away by Maxwell and cleared and sent all the way down. And now chipped at. We're going to get a penalty against the Panthers.
So, no, there was a high stick on the puck when it was
being
launched.
Okay, so delayed
right.
Potential high stick. The official had his arm up.
Yep.
And once again, it is
difficult.
A two-referee,
one-linesman
deal. Yep. So, yeah. So that's what it is. So they've updated the shots 51-18 now. Puck taken away and cleared. Keenel. His pass comes out. Panthers steal. They shoot it around Rash. Into the near side boards. Off of O'Rourke. Out to center. Across the red line. Panthers to regroup. Ferguson to bring it in. Drops it back. Taken away. Ferguson with it again. To the point. Too far for Gilligan to set it up. He'll bring it back out. Panthers regroup. Into the near side boards. Puck coughed up. Taken by Harrop. And it's cleared out to center. 3 minutes to go in the third. Now here come the Panthers. A pass that comes in. And deflects out in front. Ferguson got the shot. Deflected off of Keenel. And we are going to get potential penalties here. And the official only saw the second half of that. Oh, no, we are going to get both. It's a cross check and a unsportsmanlike. O'Rourke gets unsportsmanlike, 2 minutes. And then Garofalo is going in.
Some exciting 4-on-4 hockey for the last 3 minutes of the game.
Yeah, the Panthers scored their 2-1 goal on 4-on-4. So we'll catch the call.
Cougars
here.
Penalty called on number 22, Nick Garofalo. 2 minute minor penalty for checking from behind. Panthers penalty called on number 10, Ethan O'Rourke. 2 minute minor penalty for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Those are the penalties there. Now there's 1:36 remaining. 2:27 to go in the period. Robin steers a shot aside. Panthers try to work it out of their own zone. With 2:20 to go and a 3-2 lead, worst lead in hockey. Puck flipped down. Fournier off the boards, gets a shot off. It's fought off by Roush, but it's cleared. Panthers keep it in. Fournier with it right side. Now up the middle, Young Menard with a drive and a blocker saved by Roush, and he'll hold on. .109 remaining in the coincidentals. 2:02 remaining in the third period. 52-18 are the shots. Panthers win the draw. O'Connor drive in, save, rebound, loose, and it is Hawley with it. He's going to bring it out. 4-on-4, plenty of time. Hawley will set things up with 1:47 to go. Oh, getting hit into the boards is Serrato. Apparently not a penalty. Now 1:33 to go. Some open ice hitting now. Here come the Panthers. SIUE changing. Here is out in front looking for a shot, Hawley. The puck is loose. and bodies all over the place. Still some tussling with O'Connor. And SIUE's assistant captain, Schreiber. We're going to get a timeout called by SIUE, so we're going to take a quick timeout. We'll be back. 3-2 Drury with 1:17 left in the third.
This is Barrel Bob, MoDOT's Work Zone spokesbarrel. You'll be seeing more of me as the weather warms up. Crews will be working on our roads. That means lanes will be closed for construction and maintenance work on our highways. As you approach a work zone, please don't drive distracted. You need to pay attention. I want you and my friends working on the roads to all get home safely. Remember, buckle up and put down your phone. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton, Ice Arena Scott, listening to the Missouri Department of Transportation talk about a lot of traffic and stuff. I'll tell you what, where I live, all of a sudden in the past maybe month, there's been more traffic where I live than I have seen in forever. Getting off my road in the morning, it's a road where there's a school. I kid you not, sometimes you have to wait 5 minutes for wall-to-wall traffic. Well, we don't have 5 minutes. We have 1:16 left. We'll see what happens here, and we'll see if SIUE pulls rash. I guess that would be a rash decision. And they do pull him right now with 1 minute remaining. Robbins is able to clear. No, he's not. Good play as it was held in by Hara. Over to the corner. Tipped up and over the net. Now back around into the near side. Now with 44 seconds remaining. Puck is cleared, but it's been tipped apparently. No icing. Maxfield. He'll get it. He'll send it down. This should be an icing, although no racing to keep it not is Summer. 24 seconds remaining. Now with 17, Panthers are just content to let the clock run. And finally, the officials blow the play dead with 12.7 seconds left. 3-2, Drury. They are hoping to move to 5-2 this season. Southern Illinois, Edwardsville, they are 1-5-1.
And we got a Drury penalty here.
Yeah, that's not going to be good, especially you're trying to kill off time and you get called for a penalty, and it's going to be Young Menard. Ten penalties, 20 minutes. Sixth power play for the Cougars, and they have an empty net. So this will be a 6-on-4 with 12.7 seconds left. The key is winning the draw. Panthers cannot. Comes right out in front. Kept in. Here's a drive. Shot missing wide. 5 seconds to go. Up high. Maxwell shoots. It missed wide. 2 seconds, and that'll do it. The Drury Panthers, for the most part, escaped this game. 3-2, they'll win it. Outshooting their opponent 56-19. But Southern Illinois Edwardsville makes their 1-5-1 record not that important, because they gave Drury all they could and came up short.
I got to assume 56 shots in a game is pretty close to his high.
Yeah, we will. Verify that tomorrow. But Finley gets two. First one on a power play at 8:38 of the second. No scoring in the first. Maxfield on a power play makes it 1-1. That was Maxfield's third of the season. Drury comes back at 17-11 on a 4-on-4 goal. Fournier with the assist, or excuse me, with the goal, that is. Abel with the assist, 2-1. LaRose makes it 2-2. Harup and Cuts, that at 4-12 of the third. And then at 12-09, Finley, his third, second of the game. Young Menard and Ferguson. In fact, it's been Young Menard and Ferguson on both Finley goals. 3-2 is the final. Scott, if you can believe this, 30 shots on Roush in the third period for a three-period total of 56. And just, let me do my math here, 11 in the third period on Robbins for a three-period total of 19. Power plays, the Panthers were 1-for-3. The Cougars of SIUE were 1-for-6. And the Drury Panthers improved to 5-2 on the season. 1-6-1 are the Southern Illinois Edwardsville Cougars. That'll do it for us here at Jordan Valley Ice Park and the Stan Melton Ice Arena. Again, the Drury Panthers come out victorious, but you wouldn't have known it if you just looked at the shot count. Again, the final score, 3-2. Drury wins it on a late goal by Finley. And they improved to 5-2 on the season. SIUE 1-6-1. Fans have filed out of Jordan Valley Ice Park. We're just about to say goodbye. For Scott Lutzke and for my cameraman. And, you know, I just want to say a real quick thing. I really love, Amari, your TikToks. Keep them going. They're awesome.
I appreciate it a lot. Thank you.
All right. Well, till tomorrow, everyone, have a good night.